acceptable feed, both for animals and for humans. It is important that we allow the microbes in their trillions to play their part in trying to mitigate or reduce the effect of aflatoxins in the feeds that we give to our animals. And that is why dairy meal should be pre-digested using MolaPlus livestock microbes. Made stovers, wheat bran, or things like rice jam, or things like wheat straws or barley straws, all of them should pass through a pre-digestion stage using MolaPlus livestock microbes. Then we shall have played our part in bringing to the table a more healthier and safer food. When you look at this cow dung is a bit pasty. It is fine. It is not very hard and not very watery. A good farmer should always pay attention to the kind of cow dung their cows are releasing. In developed economies like the US, farmers sample out their cow dung and take it to analysis. But here in Africa, we are still developing. We may require to be keen just to note what are the characteristics of a good cow dung. In contrast, when you look at this cow dung, this one is a bit hard. It's a bit ringy, it has rings. You watch properly, you will see an element of mucus. This, when you see this, you realize that you have got to do something about digestion and utilization of nutrients in your farm. Here. It is also fibrous. You see, it is fibrous. You can see mucus. This means that cow should be assisted to digest the feed properly. Now, you would say, if this is Njiko farm and they're using microbes, why then are we having these two kind of cow dung in the same farm? This cow dung has come from this cow. When you look at this cow is sick currently. Currently, this cow is sick. And because it is sick, the cow is not eating well, is not digesting properly, and is not doing well. We recommend a cow like this to be given MolaPlus livestock microbe drenching. You can put in water, 50 milliliters, let the cow take direct in her water. Can take day one, can take day two, day three. By around 4 or 5 days, the cows will start now digesting the feed properly. Because the population of the microbes in the rumen will have multiplied and they will have increased. The higher their population, the more effective her ability to utilize feed will be. So that later on, if you come and watch a cow, that will not be like this, it will be like that one. And you can look at, when you look at these cows, she looks different because of that health challenge.
Area for the environment. You can bear me witness, there is no offensive smell in this farm. One of the ways that you can tell your animals are comfortable or not, whether they are well fed or not, is the percentage of the animals which are lying down and the animals which are busy looking for food. If you look here, 80% of the animals are down. Only 20% are standing. That means the animals are comfortable and animals make milk when they are resting, not when they are busy foraging around. So by looking at this, you can tell right away whether things are okay or not. Also, our animals sleep on mattresses which are called cow mat. That is for the sake of comfort. If your animal is comfortable, it will also give you what you want, that is milk. The mattress may sound expensive, 2,500 shillings per mat, but the animals will give you that in return. These animals have been brought in here for milking. We shall start milking in a few minutes. And as you can see, Our animals do not eat anything when they are being milked, because they took all that they needed when they were eating the TMR. That makes sure that the environment remains clean and the animals don't give a lot of problems when you're milking. Once you have taken milk from the cow, that milk is usually sterile, and you must make sure that it remains as sterile as possible before getting to the market. The best way of doing that is by chilling that milk. Like, we use this chiller to about 4 degrees centigrade as quickly as you can from the cow. And that milk must come to 4 degrees within less than 5 minutes. But the sooner, the better. Sometimes, like today, there is no electricity, so we need other methods of making the milk cool. And here we are using a water bath to keep our milk cool. Otherwise, milk is very perishable, it will go bad. And once in a while, no matter how much you try, you may have milk that goes bad or milk that has got mastitis. This milk we don't throw away. That is what we use to feed our calves. Because here we feed our calves on fermented milk, not fresh milk. One, that milk is pre-digested one stage, so the calf absorbs.
We've talked to you about our products called MolaPlus Livestock Microbes. But apart from MolaPlus Livestock Microbes, we produce a product called MolaPlus Super, which is a milk booster. It is purely designed to help a dairy cow increase milk production. It increases milk because it has energy, it has protein, it has minerals, it has trace elements, it has vitamins, and it also has a yeast that assists animals to digest the feed that they take. When you use it, it is sufficient, and it really would help you. You would start seeing milk increase by the third day. By the fourth day, you are sure your animal has increased milk. We also have another product for poultry called MolaPlus Poultry Microbes. Apart from that, in collaboration with Mengengai Agrovet and Jiko Farm, we also offer consultancy to farms in milk production, in fodder utilization, in fodder conservation, and we connect with you.